So you have a musical background, obviously, of course, but tell us a little bit about how you got into music production.
Well, I was always in a bar band back in the days. Back in the 80s, I had a Commodore 64 on stage. Then I moved up to an Atari, moved to LA, got a gig with Earth, Wind & Fire, doing behind the curtain playback at first, and then eventually getting on stage. Then I did Madonna 1990 with an Atari, which was like making fire with two rocks, man. Eight meg samplers playing, four loading off 44 meg SideQuest cartridges, while the other four are playing, praying to God that they load, because if they don't, I'm screwed. So then the next four start playing, and then I would send a program change and tell it to load the next ones over here. So it was all automated, no backup. I did have a backup Atari, but I would have to pull out the other one, put in the other one, and get screamed at by Madonna for about 20 minutes. And it never happened, so it was good. Switched to Motu in 1991, and suddenly from making fire with two rocks, I had a flamethrower. It was incredible. And went out and did Paula Abdul with that. And, you know, just all the women and a few guys. Michael Jackson, I got to work with Henley. He was great. Barry Manilow was awesome to work for. So, man, I guess, you know. And I used to play more. I was on stage with Earth, Wind & Fire, Madonna, Mariah, Paula Abdul's musical director for a while. But now the gig is behind a curtain, so I don't care. I'm an old fart, has been, so.
Have you kept a lot of this gear over the years?
You know, I used to get rid of it. Now I wish I hadn't. I mean, I've got a G4 SCSI set up in my storage locker because I still need to go through the SCSI drives because Glitter became number one again. Who'd have knew? Who knew?
OS 922? You
know? So I had to find the multis from Glitter. Mm-hmm. And, of course, nobody has them. But, so you have to save everything. And you got to have save old computers that can open these old files.